A Sandia Park couple accused of molesting their children and encouraging them to have sex with each other could be back on the street soon.
Today, a judge lowered the bond for Matthew and Cheryl Cox, and a spokesperson for the DA's office isn't happy. Here's Action 7 News anchor Tanya Mendes.
The district attorney's office fought hard against the bond reduction, saying the mother had already violated the terms by sending cards and gifts to her children when she's not supposed to have contact at all. And now the DA's office is worried that this couple will get out and try to reach out again. They've been behind bars for weeks, but probably not for much longer.
They own a home and cars and other property, and so we expect they'll be out as early as this afternoon.
Matthew and Cheryl Cox are self-described nudists, but they're accused of taking nudity to the next level. The Coxes are facing a slew of charges for allegedly molesting their children and then encouraging the children to touch and have sex with one another. Today, a judge reduced the parents' bond to $100,000 apiece.
Each one possibly could be released if they can post as little as just 3% of that.
$3,000 buys little peace of mind for the district attorney's office.
These folks are facing serious charges, are likely to face a number of other serious charges if additional allegations are sustained. And clearly they've already demonstrated a contempt for the very basic rules of the court.
The DA spokesperson Pat Davis says Cheryl Cox sent letters and gifts to the same children she's accused of fondling. And while New Mexico's laws give parents a lot of latitude when it comes to how they raise their children, you can't cross into a criminal lifestyle.
Every parent has a right to raise their child the way they feel is appropriate, up to a point. And whatever that line is, the Coxes, if these allegations are proven, whatever that line is, the Coxes have clearly crossed it.
Now, Pat Davis says there is a silver lining. The fact that the couple is now able to get out on bond will give the DA's office more time to investigate this case. Davis says once the Coxes are not in custody, the speedy trial issues are not as pertinent.
The DA's office says more charges are likely. The children remain in protective custody.